Not the way, neither is this the city. Follow me, and I will bring you to the man whom ye seek.
But he led them to Samaria.
Walked upon the roof of the king's house, and from the roof
sent and inquired after the woman and said,
"Is that not Bathsheba, daughter of Eliam?
And wife of Uriah the Hittite?"
And David sent messengers and took her. From her uncleanness, and she returned unto her house. And the woman conceived, and sent, and told David, and said,
"I am with child."
And David said to Joab,
"Send me Uriah the Hittite."
Joab sent Uriah unto David, and when Uriah was come unto him, David demanded how Joab did, and how the people did, and how the Lord prospered. And David said to Uriah,
"Go down to thine house, and wash thy feet."
Assigned Uriah to a place where he knew that valiant men were, and
And the men in the city went out and fought with Joab, and there fell some of the people of the servants of David. Then Joab sent and told David all the things concerning the war, and charged the messenger, saying,
"When thou hast made an end of telling the matters of the war unto the king, and if so be that the king's wrath arise, and he say unto thee, Wherefore approach ye so nigh to the city when he did fight, hear ye not that they would shoot from the wall? Who smote Abimelech, the son of Jerubbaal?
So the messenger went and came and showed David all the things concerning the war. And the messenger said unto David,
"Surely the men prevailed against us and came out unto us into the field, and we were upon them even unto the entering of the gate. And the shooters shot from off the wall upon thy servants, and some of thy servants be dead, and thy servant Uriah the Hittite is dead also."
And David said unto the messenger,
"Thus shalt thou say unto Joab, Let not this thing displease thee, for the sword devoureth one as another. But make thy paddle more strong against the city, and overthrow it. And encourage thou him."
And when the wife of Uriah heard that Uriah, her husband, was dead, mourned for her husband. And when the morning was past, David sent and fetched her to his house, and she became his wife, and bare him a son.
My master's house and my master's wife. wives unto thy bosom, and in the house of Israel and of Judah. And if men had been too little, I would moreover have given unto thee such and such things.
Whether God would be gracious to me that the child may live.
But now he is dead, wherefore shouldst I fast? I can't bring him back. I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me.
And David comforted Bathsheba his wife, and he went in unto her, and he lay with her, and she bare a son, and he called his name
Solomon.
And the Lord loved him.
Speech pleased the Lord that Solomon had asked this thing. And God said unto him,
because thou hast done this thing, and hast not asked for thyself long life, neither hast asked riches for thyself, nor hast asked the life of thine enemies, but hast asked for thyself understanding to discern judgments.
Solomon awoke, and behold, it was a dream. And he went to Jerusalem, where he stood before the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord. And he offered up burnt offerings, and he offered peace offerings, and he made a feast unto all his servants.
Oh! son is the dead, my son is the living.
Then the king said,
bring me a sword.
So they brought a sword unto the king. And he said,
divide the living child in two and give half to one and half to the other.
Then spake the woman whose the living child was from her bowels, yearned upon her son. And she said,
oh my lord, give her the living child and in no wise slay it.
But the other woman said,
let it be neither mine nor thine, but divide it.
Then the king said,
give her the living child, and in no wise slay it, for she is the mother thereof.
Thank you.
reins of man. And he sat in the tent door in the heat of the day, and he lifted up his eyes and looked, and lo, three men stood by him. And when he saw them, he ran to meet them from the tent door, and he bowed himself toward the ground and said,
My lord, if now I have found favor in thy sight, pass not away, I pray thee, from thy servant. Let a little water, I pray you, be fetched, and wash your feet, and rest yourselves under the tree. And I will fetch a morsel of bread, and comfort ye your hearts. After that ye shall pass on. For therefore are ye come unto your servant.
And they said, So do.
As thou hast said.
And Abraham hastened into the tent unto Sarah, and said,
Make ready quickly 3 measures of fine meal, knead it, and make cakes upon the hearth.
And he ran unto the herd, and fetched the calf tender and good. And he gave it unto a young man, and he hasted to dress it.
Ha ha ha!
unto him.
Abraham.
And he said,
Behold, here I am.
And he said,
Take now thy son, thine only son Isaac, whom thou lovest, and give thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of.
And Abraham rose up early in the morning and saddled his ass and took two of his young men with him and Isaac, his son. And clave the wood for the burnt offering. And rose up and went unto the place of which God had told him. Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. And he said unto his young men,
Abide ye here with the ass. I and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to thee.
And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac, his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife.
My father.
And he said,
Here am I, my son.
And he said,
Behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering?
And Abraham said,
My son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering.
So they went, both of them together. An altar there. Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said,
Abraham! Abraham!
And he said,
Here am I!
And he said,
Lay not thine hand upon the lad. Neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me. By myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing, and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son,